This video is going to touch on the use of a stick in different situations in the defensive zone. I kind of identified three different ways. There's passive pressure, where you're just going stick on puck and not engaging the body. And then there's aggressive pressure, where the ones that we have here as an example, the player isn't even really thinking about the puck first. He's taking the body with two hands on the stick, kind of in a cross-check motion, and then trying to knock the player off and then get the puck. And the third one is kind of a hybrid between the two. So this very first one here, we'll just let it play out. We'll be watching Eric Johnson here. As we go, we'll talk about it. So very passive pressure, just stick on puck, using the stick more than the body. Slow engage, again, passive pressure, active stick, stick on puck, mirroring that puck with his stick blade, little poke check, sweep check, reads the play, gets his stick on the boards, picks it up and makes a breakout. So very passive, not engaging the body at all, really just trying to keep the guy to the outside and use a stick. The next series is all Ryan Suter. I pulled this from another fella's YouTube channel. He had a compilation of Ryan Suter, and the one thing that really stood out is how he sequences. He goes usually body first in a two hands on the stick, cross-checking, working the hips motion, and then tries to knock the player down first and then goes after the puck. So he's pretty much completely backwards of what we just seen. And the second sequence, this one's the one that's good in this, so. So the first one, again, little slash, stick up, doesn't really put stick on puck, which allows the pass to come through. Now in this sequence, he's going to engage, the Detroit player spins to protect the puck, turns his back, and now Suter has to back off a little bit. Stick is in the air, he's in a two-handed cross-check lunge, so his stick is across like this, and as you can see, this puck is still exposed, and that's the danger of this. If they have one of their players up in the slot here or in an area where he's open for a pass, that's a good way to slip pucks off of a stick to an area, because Suter's stick is up here in the it's not on the ice, so he's not taking away that passing lane. This does end up working out for him, though, because he takes the player down and then engages with stick on puck and moves it forward. So, again, there's no right and wrong way. It's just a combination. Here's the danger, though. Goes in to try to take this guy off the puck, but gets out-muscled. So now he's let the Columbus player get separation. He's now got time and space with the puck, just because that there was no stick on puck. So again, he goes in, starts stick on puck. Right here you can see his stick is down, taking away lanes. As he attacks, though, that stick comes up, and he goes back to his two hand and just starts cross-checking in the back. And again here, puck protection, comes in aggressively, cross-check in the back. Same thing, hands up. Look at the separation that's created here. By being hands on the hips, he missed that check and did a flyby, and the space created here is pretty great. If this guy knew that he was on a flyby, he'd just turn out here. He's got sticks coming. There's an opportunity for a scoring chance here. This player down here, though, didn't identify that there was a flyby on that one, so he waits and then back to being aggressive. And again here, takes the man down and then goes for the puck. He's body first, puck second. Going for the body again, takes his player down, looking for that free puck. Just keeps working the hips with the cross check, the two hands on the stick. So here we're going to get into kind of what I've been teaching, what I see as the hybrid or the combination between the two. So I watched the Calgary player here, who is this is the fellow we're going to be watching in this one, and watching his stick positioning and hand positioning on this. So here you can see top or the bottom hand is off of the stick, making contact with that, and then just one hand on the stick, free stick here, using that hand to drive and push the player, similar to what Suter was doing with his stick. But now he's got a free hand to go after that puck and try to get possession. And again, right there was a combination. He went into the two-handed lunge there. Now he's working the hips right here. So he's doing the cross check. As you can see, he's quite a bit smaller than Hanzel in this one, so he's going to have to use his power. One other thing we want to address just in the middle of this is how to bring your stick over or with you. So in this one, we're going to be watching Voyanov here, 26. So in slow motion, you can see here, he comes up, makes a poke at that puck. He's got to now switch directions, and there's some theory out there on what to do with this stick. You can see his stick is right here. I've heard some guys say the terminology is take it with you, where you don't take it in the air and up over. But as you see here, he takes his stick right over the top to get position. So watch his stick, it's coming over the top and now it's in that lane. And the trend that I've been finding is if it's a right-handed player on the right-handed side, this hand, the top hand of the stick, as he's following the player up the wall and then that player makes a cut back to come the other way, I've been seeing that this is the area where these players bring that stick over the top. In order to get it back onto this side, they bring it up and over rather than tucking it and taking it with them. So another example of it here, as we can see, it's a lefty on this side. In slow motion here, we're watching this player, left-handed defenseman on the left side. His top hand is leading here, and you'll see again, similar to Voyanov, when he hits the brakes and has to switch direction, rather than keeping that stick on the ice and sliding it behind the Sweden player's heels, it comes up and over top and is brought back down into that lane to close that lane off. And I see it as being effective. I know there's some people that say it is probably not the right way, but from what I've been seeing, I don't think there's anything wrong with it. And here we get into kind of the hybrid of the two again. So we'll be watching Mathot in this one. As you can see already, right now he's got his bottom hand free working the back, and his top hand is still on the stick here. So similar to the Calgary player we just showed. So there you can see the free hand is off the stick. Top hand remains on, goes in, makes contact with that hand, and then also fishing for the puck with that stick. So right there you can see he's got that hand out and around that player. The stick is brought down this way looking for that puck, but the free hand is on this side. So if you think about it, that Montreal player ultimately has a V around him. Mathot is almost giving him a bear hug, but without touching him. He's using that free hand to work the body, using the stick hand to go after the puck. Here's a really good example of it. This was, I think, last year, the Subway Series, Dyson Mayo here. As you can see, free hand is on the back, stick is around this side going after that puck. So again, he's almost creating a V around this player. And that's an example right there of taking the stick with you. I know it's different terminology, or maybe you haven't heard it before, but right here, rather than having that stick come up and all the way over, Again, this is a right-handed player on the left side, so his top hand is now closer to the goal line, closer to the bottom of the ice. So just in regards to that turn and the biomechanics of that turn, this is easier to take your stick with you. So as you can see, he doesn't have to take that stick up and over. It's just a pull and move behind this guy. And that's all in relation to how close you are to the player you're defending, right? So in this situation, if he wanted to take his stick right now from there and get it onto this side, how close he is, he's right on this guy's hips, he would have to go up and over to get that stick around and to the other side. That would be the most efficient, quick way, rather than what we just showed you here, rather than what he does. As this player creates separation, now with that separation, he doesn't have to take his stick up and over the top. He can just bring it across that player's heels and go back into that lane while he's turning. But again, here you can see free hand is on the back, top hand of the stick is here. He's actually built a V around this player. And that's what you're ultimately trying to do, is be able to pin him both ways and contain him. That's it. And please, again, I keep asking for it. I haven't got many comments yet, but hopefully people start watching these and making comments. This is stuff I really enjoy discussing. If you're a technical person that works in the game, please comment and provide feedback on what you've seen and what your theory is in regards to some of these videos.